Let's look at Gaussian elimination, and let's take that process, which we've performed by hand, and turn it into an algorithm. Now, what do we have here? What we have here is a 4x4 matrix with a right-hand side, so that we have the augmented system that we discussed in the opener for this week. And on the right here, I have an algorithm that implements Gaussian elimination. And to explain it, let's go over here and say, okay, well, you know, in the first phase of the algorithm, what we do is we compute a multiplier and then take that multiplier, multiply it times the first row and subtract it off the second row. Then we compute the next multiplier, do the same thing, and so forth. And then we move on and do the same thing for the smaller submatrix, and so forth. So, to discuss an algorithm, what I like to do is say, well, what's a typical state in which we find ourselves? So a typical state may be that we are currently working with this column right here, and we have already introduced zeros to the left. Now this here is the index j, which keeps track of which column is the current column where we're going to introduce zeros. And notice that that's our outer loop here, indexed by j. And what do we do in a typical step of Gaussian elimination? Well, we go find the row that we're currently working on, and we may want to index that with I. And for that row, we take the current element in the current column, column J, and we compute the multiplier. And that multiplier, if you think about it, is equal to alpha 2 1 divided by alpha 1 1, because if you take that, multiply it times the current row and subtract it off, then you end up introducing a zero there. Okay, so that's what we have right here. We have a loop, so that the index I sweeps over all of the rows below the current diagonal element, and there we compute a multiplier. And then what do we need to do? Then we need to index over all elements in the rest of the rows, of the, these two rows, and update the element in the current ith row. So we take the multiplier, multiply it times that element, subtract it off of that element, multiply it times that element, subtract it off of that element, and so forth. And that's what this loop does right here. And then when we get to the right-hand side, we take the multiplier, multiply it times the jth entry there, and subtract it off of the ith entry there. All right, and that's what this statement right here does. Now, we're going to relate this process to the computation of the LU factorization, and therefore we're not really interested in the right-hand side, and therefore I'm just going to take this out right now. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to slowly morph this into an algorithm that we can then relate to the algorithm that we presented with flame notation in the opener that we claim computes the LU factorization. And how are we going to do that? Well, notice that when you reach the current column, you can either compute the current multiplier and use it, or you can say, well, you know, I could actually go and compute all multipliers, and once I have done that, then I can turn to updating the rest of the elements in the various rows. Now, what does that mean? What that means is that we take this loop right here and we split it in two, where we first compute all of the multipliers and set the corresponding elements to zero, and then we create a second loop which marches over all of the rows and updates all of the entries to the right of the current column. And now we have this. Now let's relate this to how we partition and repartition using the flame notation. Okay? When we say we're currently at this point, what we really are saying is that we have reached this point right here, where this is A top left, A top right, A bottom left, A bottom right. Then what do? Then we expose alpha 1, 1, not to be mistaken for alpha 1, comma 1. So this entry right here is alpha 1, 1 in our flame notation. This vector right here is A2, 1. This row right here is A1, 2 transpose. And this submatrix right here is A2, 2. Okay? Now, taking these elements and one by one dividing them by alpha 1, 1 is the same as taking this vector A2, 1 and dividing it by alpha 1, 1. So this loop right here really, let's see, it takes A21 and it's up, actually it creates a vector L21 and sets it to A21 divided by alpha 1, 1. And then it takes the entire vector A21 and it sets it to a zero vector. Okay? Next, well, we have this double nested loop. And if you think about it very carefully, what that loop does is it takes this submatrix and it subtracts off the outer product that consists of A21 times A12 transpose. So this double nested loop updates A22 by subtracting off A21 times A12 transpose. Well, actually not A21 because we set that to zero, right? So I should say L21. Okay, now we're getting pretty close to something that looks like the algorithm that we claimed computed LU factorization. Now, little detail is, well, instead of creating separate multipliers in a separate vector, couldn't we just overwrite A21 and then not set A21 to zero? So now we have stored the multipliers in the elements that are being set to zero, in which case, instead of multiplying by L21, what we want to do is use A21. We want to take the outer product of A21 with A12 transpose, because A21 has been overwritten by the multipliers. And then we're done with the current column. We move forward, and so forth. So what we've done now is we've related a loop that you may have encountered before that exposes a triple nested loop, and we have related this to how we present the algorithm using flame notation. Now, the algorithm flame notation only has one loop in it. What happened to all of these other loops? Well, this loop is hidden in the operation take the vector and divide it by alpha 1, 1. And this double nested loop is hidden inside of this, what we call a rank 1 update.